In this view, we will be demonstrating the PA hand. The PA hand should be performed with the patient seated at the end of the radiographic table, with the image receptor placed tabletop, with a 40-inch source-to-image distance and no tube angulation. Our patient is at the end of the table having a seat, and we're going to have her arm at a 90-degree angle with her elbow bent, placing the hand right in the middle of the IR. We're going to center at the third metacarpal phalangeal joint. We're going to spread her digits out so they're all separated, very nice and uniformed. We're going to collimate and open the field so we include all the anatomy. You're going to see the MCP joint, the metacarpals, the carpals, and of course all phalanges, which is the proximal, the middle, and the distal phalanx. I'm going to place a marker within the light field, and the exposure is made. A diagnostic PA hand radiograph must be free of motion and rotation, with open interphalangeal and metacarpal phalangeal joints, demonstrated anatomy to include the phalanges, metacarpals, carpals, and distal radius and ulna, with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the oblique hand. The oblique hand should be performed with the patient seated at the end of the radiographic table with the image receptor placed tabletop, with a 40-inch source-to-image distance and no tube angulation. Now we're going to come back in and do the oblique. We're just going to turn her wrist up about 45 degrees, placing each finger separated, still centered at the third MCP joint. All digits are within the light field. The marker is still there, and we're going to take that exposure right there. A diagnostic oblique hand radiograph must be free of motion, 45-degree rotation, with open interphalangeal and metacarpophalangeal joints. Demonstrated anatomy to include the phalanges, metacarpals, carpals, and distal radius and ulna, with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the lateral hand. The lateral hand should be performed with the patient seated at the end of the radiographic table with the image receptor placed tabletop with a 40-inch source-to-image distance and no tube angulation. And lastly, we're going to do the lateral. We're going to place your hand up on its side like this, and I'm going to do the fan lateral, which keeps the metacarpals 90 degrees. This is a great view to show fractures and foreign bodies. You want to keep the little finger out, and then we're going to stair step every finger so that you can see each digit in the lateral view, keeping the thumb very straight. So in the fan lateral, you will collimate, showing all digits, and you will collimate an inch around and 1 inch distal or above the carpal bones. And that is the lateral, and the exposure is made. A diagnostic lateral hand radiograph must be free of motion and rotation, with open interphalangeal and metacarpal phalangeal joints. Demonstrated anatomy to include the phalanges, metacarpals, carpals, and distal radius and ulna, with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.